Because the objective of the national objective of the United States, the policy is Gaddafi has to go. But that's not the military objective of the operation. That military objective is defined by the authorizing resolution that came out of the United Nations. Now, normally, you would think that when military force is applied, you would accomplish a decisive political objective all by yourself. But that's not necessarily the case. In 1999, we did an air operation, as you know, against Milosevic, and 16 months later, Milosevic was gone. And ended
Except
up in
President
the Hague.
Bill Clinton was not repeatedly saying during that operation, Milosevic must go, was he?
No, he wasn't. But the point is that you have other means than military means. I think what the administration is trying to do is limit the military means to that authorized by the United Nations and then add other factors in there to achieve the desired political outcome.
If they've destroyed Libya's, let's say they destroyed the whole Libyan Air Force, I don't think they have, but let's say they did, let's say they destroyed all of Libya's air defense systems, they still have a lot of ground forces. They have tanks, they have artillery, they have all sorts of weapons. They could still endanger civilians, the opposition, if you will. Does the no-fly zone, in effect, need to be broadened to include, in order to back up the UN Security Council resolution, a no-drive zone as well?
Well, they have the authority to do that, actually, with any of these forces that are threatening. The question is, can it be done from the air, and can it be done at the from the altitudes with the number of aircraft overhead? And probably it's going to take some more aircraft overhead. It may take, at some point, unmanned aerial vehicles so you can stare at the ground and really pick it out. And it may take attack helicopters coming in or some aircraft going lower so the pilots have a little bit better view of what's happening on the ground.
Is it time to start arming the rebels?
They're certainly calling for it from everything that I hear, but I also think there's a lot of arms around there. This is something the political committee that France is going to head is going to have to decide. It's not within the UN Security Council resolution, and it'd be a whole lot better if we don't have to arm the rebels to achieve the political objective that the president has cited.
When you say the political objective, you mean getting rid of Gaddafi?
Right, right. I it's very possible, Wolf, that the impact of the air campaign here may be strong enough and disheartening enough for Gaddafi's forces that a majority of them will just melt away. People will come back out again and take their chance on Gaddafi's snipers and the residual loyalist troops. One thing that has to be done is there is an entry point in Libya in the far south near the border with Chad and Sudan in which these mercenaries are still coming in. And surely at some point we're going to take a hard look at that from the air.
I'm sure the U.S. will, if it hasn't already, together with the British and the French. We got a lot more to discuss, and we will in the coming days. General, thanks very much.
Thank you.